Hi, AT from CNC at Home. I wanted to go into LightBurn and show you a new layer feature that's been added. Not quite sure how I would use it. There are people out there, obviously, that would use this, and I wanted to just cover it real quickly so that you knew it was there and the basics of how it worked. I'm going to start by opening up a tile template, my 110mm tile template. We'll zoom in on that. And then I'm going to put the letter T in the middle of that, just for fun. So there's a big letter T, and if I move this up, I can get it to snap to the center. Nothing fantastic or interesting about that. Let's go ahead and get our burn parameters set for that. I'm going to be doing a black tile. So I'll go ahead and grab my tile black parameters and assign that. And I want to make sure that this actually gets through the paint, so I am going to slow it down quite a bit. I'm going to go 2,000 millimeters per minute, and I'm going to bump the power up to 70%. So the basics would just be fill. We'll do a preview real quickly. It looks like that, nothing fancy. Let's go and look at that layer again. So I just double click on the layer. And what I'm going to do is change the line interval to 1 millimeter, which is going to be pretty wide. Let's take a look and see what that does. If we look at the preview, see how it spaces the lines out quite a bit. And that's not going to really fill in on the laser. It's going to literally make lines. But I don't want just vertical lines, so I'm going to change the angle to 135 so they go diagonally like this. All right, everything looks good. Now, here's where the new feature comes in. You'll notice up here we have our first layer on this layer. I can add a layer to my layer. And we want this one to also be fill, and I want it to be 1 millimeter, and the angle on this one's going to be 45. So that's going to be 90 degrees different from the first layer. And we'll do 2,070, so our power settings and speed will be the same. When we take a look at our preview, now you can see this cross hatch thing that it's going to be doing. Well, obviously our first layer got changed here, so let's get that set back. I'm not quite sure why that got set back, but we'll get that set. There we go. Now we'll look at our preview. There's our crosshatch that we were expecting. So it'll do the first layer crosshatch, then it'll come back and do the other crosshatch. To make this a little cooler, don't know if this is actually going to work with my laser, I'm going to add one more layer. Make sure that these parameters stayed the same. Okay. And this one, I am going to keep as line. And so what that will do is it'll trace around our letter and kind of give it a nice border. Again, I'm going to change the burning parameters so that they're the same. Did I do 70 or 75? 70. Click OK. And when we do our preview, now we see we have this border. What we've been able to do in LightBurn now is in a single layer, we can effectively have three separate layers. So without having to copy our letter T into, you know, I have three objects and then set three layers down here with the different parameters, I can do it all in this single one. So pretty straightforward, pretty easy to do. Again, not quite sure how I would use this, but there are times where this might come in useful. Burning metal, for instance, burning with the grain and against the grain has different results, and there might be a time where you want to do something with and something against. Maybe a first pass, second pass kind of thing. This is where this comes in. Let's go ahead and save this, take it over to the laser, and see how it actually burns. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Unfortunately, the recording of the burn didn't save properly, but here's what it looks like after we went through and did both the cross-hatching and then the border. It seemed to cut through pretty nicely. The next step will be to get this over to the sink and clean it up. Here we can see that it looks a little whiter now that it's been cleaned up. What I like to do is get this under the microscope. Here's the corner of that T. Let's get zoomed in a little bit. And interestingly, the width of the lines is different. The initial crosshatch that was 135 is skinny, and the one at 45 is thicker. That's due to the shape of the laser. It's not actually a dot, it's more of a diamond shape. Anyway, looks really good zoomed in. This is kind of an interesting way to do layers. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you like the content of our channel, please think about subscribing. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.